In this example, we're going to create a program to calculate the total number of calories in a food given the number of grams of fat, carbohydrates, and protein in the food. A gram of fat would be equivalent to 9 calories. A gram of protein or carbohydrate would both be 4 calories. So given that problem statement, let's fill in our IPO chart. So first things first, what are they asking us for? The total number of calories. So let's fill that in first. Okay, so we'll fill in here total calories, and we have our output statement, our output variable. Okay, back at the problem statement, we notice that we're given as input the number of grams of fat, carbohydrates, and protein. So we have 3 inputs, and we'll fill those in here on our IPO chart. Okay, so we'll fill in fat, carbohydrates, and protein. The last thing we have to do is figure out our process. How do we calculate the total calories? And we'll have several processes here. First, we have a calculation for each of the 3 different sources of calories, fat, carbohydrates, and protein. So we have that calculation first. So let's look at fat first, which would be the equivalent of 9 calories per gram. So we'll go back and fill that in on our IPO chart. Okay, so the total number of fat calories would be equal to the number of fat grams times 9, as it said in the problem statement. Taking a look at the other 2, we see they should be similar. Protein or carbohydrates would be 4 calories per gram. So we'll fill those assignment statements out on our IPO chart. So calories from carbohydrates would be the grams of carbohydrates times 4. The number of protein calories would also be the grams in proteins multiplied times 4. We have one more calculation to make because we're not quite to our output yet. We still have to calculate the total number of calories, which would be each of our categories added together. So total calories is equal to fat calories, carb calories, protein calories. Okay, I separated out each formula for our process. Just so it'd be a little bit clearer, we could see what we have here. Notice now our problem is only slightly more complicated. So you can kind of see the value of the IPO chart in helping you break things out. What are my inputs? What are my outputs? And how do I get from the inputs to the outputs? So you definitely want to take advantage of your IPO chart and use that to help you keep track of what you're doing.
Okay, let's put that problem in C++. We'll do a new project. Console, we'll call it calories. And let's go ahead and save that. And we get our template. Turn off that view. And go ahead and change this. And first thing we would do is go back to our IPO chart and basically fill in the variables. To save a little time, I went ahead and typed those in and edited. Next thing we would do is put in our inputs. And voila, we have our 3 input statements. One thing, I don't know if we've done this before, one thing to note about the declaration of variables here, we have double fat, comma, carbohydrates, comma, protein. That's declaring 3 different variables as double, as opposed to declaring each one individually. Double fat, semicolon, double carbohydrates. This is just an abbreviated form, and will accomplish the same thing. Okay, so we have our variable declaration, we have our inputs, we need to put in our processing. Okay, and so just like that, we have our processing statements put in. Don't forget your semicolons on the end. And last but not least, we add in our output. Okay, and with a little bit fancier set of output statements here, We can execute that, compile and run. Let's pick something like 10 grams of fat, 20 grams of carbohydrate, and 5. We can get a little bit fancier output, so it reads more like a sentence. The total calories for 10 grams of fat, 20 grams of carbohydrates, and 5 grams of protein adds up to 190 calories. So you may want to take a look at this a little bit more and see how that works out.